Congressman Michael Nowakowski, and welcome to this segment of Phoenix 2020, A Clear Vision for the Future. And on this segment, we're going to go down Cityscape where we have Surfing on Central. We're going to talk about water safety and all the great things you can do this summer in downtown Phoenix. Also, we're going to talk about the new program that we have, a trash pickup program for the city of Phoenix. So we're going to get more information on that. And we're right here with my family at Smith Park, where we're going to have our 16th movie in the park this year, where we bring out a movie screen, we bring out all kinds of toys and gifts and giveaways, and people have fun, and we take back our neighborhood and have a great time in the movie. So come on down and let's watch E.T.
I'm gonna get you home, all right?
That is so crazy.
Find a way.
Someone's coming. We should go.
All right, we're here with one of our sponsors, 42 West and A Vision. These are individuals that come out and they sponsor these great movies in the park. And why are you guys do this? Or why are you out here promoting?
We think it's a good idea to give back to the community. We'll be giving away some, I guess, beach balls, some stickers, some bicycle helmets, as well as a little lights to, for them to put on the bicycle. We're also going to try and educate kids on how to ride their bikes. So,
you know, it's so great that we have companies here in Phoenix that care about the community, that give back to the inner city kids and sponsor these movies in the park. This is our 16th movie in the park this year, and it's because of sponsors like yourselves that give back to the community. Why are we watching E.T., and what's this whole Echo about?
It's basically about an alien that falls from Earth and interacts with these kids. It's basically another E.T. movie.
Oh, wow. And you know what? A bunch of these kids are going to actually get a premiere ticket, a ticket to go watch this before it even hits the movie theaters, you know? So these lucky winners out here for coming out to the movie in the park, sometimes you get free movie passes. Sometimes you get beach balls. Sometimes you get helmets. Sometimes you get shirts. You don't know what you're going to get, but come on out and keep watching Phoenix 2020, A Clear Vision for the Future, and keep looking us up on Facebook and look us up on our website, because you never know when a movie in the park is coming your way or when you're going to get these great gifts. And I just want to thank you once again. And what do you want to tell everybody about Echo?
It's a great film. Everybody should come and watch it. It's definitely a family movie that everybody would enjoy.
All right, we're here at the movie in the park at Smith Park, and we have Terry and some of the ladies that help out here with the program that we have out here to take back our neighborhood. So Terry, tell us a little bit about the movie in the park and the whole duck program that we have.
Okay, well, the duck program is awesome. It's the Downtown Urban Community Kids. We have our director, Kathleen Harris, right here, right behind me. And they've really brought a lot out to our neighborhood as far as keeping our kids involved in the community, teaching the kids how to give back to the community. The movie in the park is great. You guys bring us here every once in a while. This is our third one, so everybody's excited. Duck program is, awesome for our kids in the community.
You know what? We have some ladies that are out here that only speak Spanish, right? So, ¿por qué es tan importante tener estos tipos de programas y una película para los niños?
Porque venimos y convivimos todas las familias. Nos reunimos todas y pues mire.
Yeah, she says it's so important to bring the families together, and if you can see, there's a lot of families, and it's a way for us to get to know each other. So, you know, we have Kathleen here. That tell us a little bit about why you all started this program out here.
Well, Downtown Urban Community Kids has been around since 1995, and so the essence of what we do is keep kids in school, because we feel like that building that foundation of education is the most important thing that we can do. But then beyond that is also reaching out to the neighborhood, and so our vision statement is transforming neighborhoods through learning, living, and loving one kid at a time.
So tell us about the duck program. What does the duck stand for?
Downtown Urban Community Kids. And so during the school year, we're all about homework. And so we help the kids with their homework. We also do enrichment activities, which help them with their testing, and do other activities such as dance and art and music and science and those kinds of things.
You know, we're right here on Buckeye and about 40th Avenue, and what a great community. You know, we've cleaned this neighborhood for about 15 blocks about a month ago, and we had everybody come out here. We had about 200 volunteers from ASU, from all different nonprofit organizations, and the neighbors themselves, and we're really taking back this neighborhood one family at a time and one child at a time. And you know what? This Duck program, this after-school program, it's all about education. It's through education we're going to end poverty. It's through education we're going to end domestic violence and gang violence. And I just really want to thank you for partnering up with your Parks and Rec to make this all possible. And look at this great turnout we have in the movies in the park. Simon says, all right, are you guys having fun yet? Did everybody get a helmet? Simon says, go, stop. Okay. All right, Simon says, go and stop. I can't hear you. Do they deserve a ticket to go see Echo?
What would you do if you saw a dog, a cat, or a horse that looked like this? Animal cruelty and neglect is a crime that needs to be reported.
I'm Councilwoman Thelda Williams, here with my rescued pets, Henry and Cheyenne.
And I'm Councilman Michael Nowakowski, asking for your help.
If you ever suspect animal cruelty, call Crime Stop, the Arizona Humane Society, or the Sheriff's Office.
Animal cruelty is a crime.
And together, we could stop it.
Welcome back to Phoenix 2020, a clear vision for Phoenix. I'm Councilman Michael Nowakowski. Phoenix has a history of leading the way when it comes to reducing what ends up in the landfill. Here to talk about the two new programs that would raise the bar once again in Phoenix is Public Works Director John Trujillo. Welcome, John.
Thank you, Councilman. Glad to be here.
And congratulations, you're our new Director for Public Works.
Yes, I'm excited about that, to lead our department in new directions and helping the city become a world-class city.
So John, tell us a little bit about who John is. Just as the new director, people would like to know who you are.
I come from a small town, Miami, Arizona, born and raised there. And I went off, went to school, came back, worked in Globe, Gila County for 10 years as the Public Works Director, and had an opportunity to come down to Phoenix, and I got hired to be the assistant director, and now I'm the director of the department. So it's exciting.
Wow, and it's exciting that we have two new programs to reduce everything that goes into the landfill. A lot of times people think that what you throw in the garbage just goes straight into the landfill. Like if you live in South Phoenix, people think that the 27th Avenue and Buckeye landfill is where everything ends up. Is that true or not?
No, it's not. It's amazing when people say they throw their garbage away. What does away mean?
Right.
And so away means for us is we'll travel 4 million miles collecting garbage from residents. And then we take that garbage to the transfer stations, which we have two, one north, one south. And then from there, we travel an additional 3 million miles transporting that garbage to the landfill. So we travel 7 million miles a year just collecting and disposing of garbage. And to put that in perspective, that's equal to going to the moon and back 14 times.
Holy cow.
So it's a big program, a big city, and it's something we're trying to minimize the impact we have on the amount of miles that we travel.
So minimizing it means these new programs are gonna help us to kind of sort out the waste products that end up in the...
That's true, that is the goal of Councilman. And we do have two new programs, and the first program that we're rolling out is the Say R&R program. And basically that's, which is save as you reduce and recycle. And what we're trying to do is get residents to recycle more. And by doing that, we're offering residents a smaller container, garbage container, at a lower cost. So instead of paying $26.80 for the larger container, they can get a smaller container at $23.80, which is $3 cheaper. And by doing that, we're hoping residents will take more time and effort to take more garbage, more recycled material that would go into the garbage and put it into the recycling container. So that's the goal of that program. The other program we're rolling out is a curbside green organics program. And that's there's a lot of green organics material that gets thrown into the garbage container. So it's a voluntary program, and residents can voluntarily opt in to get a tan container, which is a third container, for curbside customers only, and they can throw their green organics material into that container. We then take that material and take it to a site next to the transfer station, and we have a mulching program that's taking effect starting July 1st. And so we will take that material and mulch it and recycle that material for other purposes.
So starting in July, we'll have all these programs started. So if you wanted one of those mulch cans, those tan ones, I know I do. We have five children at home, and sometimes that green garbage can is not enough for all the garbage and all the waste leaves and grass.
Correct.
And all that product. So how can I sign up?
There's several ways you can sign up. You can go online at phoenix.gov/publicworks, and there's a form we're getting ready to go live. People can sign up, or you can call our call center at 602-262-7251, and we'll be happy to get them signed up for that program. The green curbside organics container, it's a $5 per month. However,
that's reasonable.
There it is, and there's a lot of residents that have a number of green containers because it's not enough for the amount of garbage, and that extra container, they're paying $13.40. So if they take that one away and have a tan container, they save $8. So there is a savings for those residents that have multiple garbage containers.
Also, if you trim your tree and you need those clippings, or if you clean out your garage or so and you have all this extra waste, you can actually call and get picked up individually, right?
Yes, we do have a program. It's more of an on-call system. If residents have a big cleanup and they need a bigger container, they can call, we'll drop off the container at their house, and then we'll take it away. There is a cost to that program if they can't wait for bulk trash. We do have a quarterly bulk trash program where if they can wait, then they can leave it out, and that's part of their $26.80 per month. But if it's something beyond the quarterly bulk trash, or they can't go to the transfer station themselves, we'd be happy to bring a container and drop it off, and they can fill it up and we'd take it away.
So John, how do you find out when the bulk trash is actually in your neighborhood?
We have several ways you can do. You can call the number again, mm-hmm. or you can go online and look up and type in your address, and they will tell you exactly when the next collection day would be. So that's, we would like residents to use the website because there's a lot of information on there on bulk trash and a lot of information on when the collection days, location of the transfer stations, and everything else as relates to the garbage and recycling.
Now, is it
program.
Still in the newspaper?
Yes, we do send it out. We also send out every year about October, November, we'll send out a schedule for the year. So we do send that out about November, December. They'll be receiving a schedule for the following year.
And bulk trash is collected how many times a year?
Four times a year. Once every quarter.
Oh, that's great. So John, the other thing too is organic waste. What is that?
Organics waste for us, there's two components to organics waste. One is the green part of it, which is your tree trimmings, your grass, your shrubbery. That's more green organics material. Then there's a food organics material. And right now our program's not gonna allow food organics. However, starting about 2016, we are under design for a composting system that we will start accepting food waste in the future. So in the future, residents will be able to utilize their tan container for food waste so we can recycle that as well. And so that program's gonna be going into effect in about another year, year and a half.
Now the blue cans are actually for recycling,
correct?
Right? So what can you actually recycle? What are some like pizza boxes and stuff like that? Or how can you find those items that you can recycle? Because I know we get calls all the time.
Yes.
We have that little chart that you all gave
right.
us, and we take them to our public meetings, and people are always saying, oh, thank you, because we're always wondering, what can you put in the recycling bin, what you can't?
And part of our Reimagine Phoenix program is to better educate and communicate to our residents on what can and cannot be recycling. So, you know, you have one example that we do have information on our website. We would love to come to public meetings and educate your constituents about what can and cannot be recycled. But when you talk about pizza boxes, you can recycle pizza boxes, but if there's a lot of food, grease, and stuff on the bottom, we'd prefer you just tear the lid off, recycle the lid, and throw the food box away. In the future, you will be able to recycle that food box in the Green Organics program in the future. But for right now, they're going to have to throw it away.
So when you, like Christmas time comes around, and you have all those wrappings and plastic, you can throw the box away, but you should throw the wrapping in the regular garbage, right?
It depends on the wrapping. If it's more of a paper type wrapping, we do accept that in recycling. But if it's, you get a lot of the styrofoam type stuff and a lot of the plastic type wrapping and the ribbon and stuff, we don't recycle that. That can be thrown away. But there's a lot of other outlets for that. People can reuse it, and some people are pretty creative on how to utilize these other stuff that normally gets thrown away. And that's going to be part of our education program on how to get residents to reuse the material rather than throwing it away.
Well, John, I just want to congratulate you on being the new director. And there's about 1,100 staff members that are underneath you, right, in Public Works?
It's a large program. Public Works entails facility maintenance, equipment maintenance, and all of solid waste. So it's approximately 1,100 employees, great employees that it takes to run this city. And so it's an exciting time for us. And, you know, with the new city manager and stuff, we're going in the right direction. And I'm excited on what we're going to be doing and the changes we're going to make this a world-class city now and into the future.
Well, thank you, John, for everything you do. And congratulations once again.
Thank you.
And thanks to all Public Works employees that you keep our city looking clean and imagining a whole different Phoenix than when I was growing up.
Thank you.
Stay tuned. There's more of Phoenix 2020 coming up after this short break.
My friends and I want to help make sure everyone is safe and enjoying the water this summer.
Every year we answer dozens of calls involving water-related incidents that may have been avoided had the victims received some basic instruction.
All non-swimmers should wear a life jacket anytime they are around water. With just the basic skills learned in the city's entry-level lessons, children will be able to have a fun and safe time around water.
Be a star! Take swim lessons!
Summer is here, and if you want to cool down, we're right here at Cityscape, the place where you can ice skate during the holidays, where you have volleyball, you have concerts, and now we have surfing on Central. Can you believe that? We don't even have an ocean in Arizona, but we have surfing on Central right here at Cityscape. And the person that brought this all together was Jeff. Jeff, you come up with these crazy ideas. You have ice skating rings, you have now surfing on Central. Tell us a little bit about it.
Yeah, you know, 2 years ago, we were at a shopping center's convention in Las Vegas, and inspired by what you see out at Mission Beach called the Wave House.
Right.
We saw this concept and thought this would be the perfect kind of anti-ice rink event in the summertime, and brought a little bit of Mission Beach here, and with it came Sean Silvera from Flow Rider. Sean's the four-time world champion. He's here with us all summer to teach all the kids how to do this. Most of our customers that come have never done it before. And we've got kids all the way from 3 years old to adults that are 65 years old that come out and do everything on it.
Well, Sean, tell us a little bit about this. This is like a wave right here on Central Avenue at Cityscape. It's incredible.
Yeah. What we have behind you is Flow Rider Mobile Inflatable. So it's all inflatable. It's soft, safe. Under the surface you see is a submersible pump. It pumps 15,000 gallons through it and shoots it over the surface at 3 inches thick. So that water's going about 25 miles an hour right now.
So you can actually surf, boogie board.
Yeah.
You can do all kinds
of
stuff,
right?
Yeah,
you can stand up, you can lay on your stomach, you can get on your knees. It's fun for everyone.
He saw multiple times he can flush a 180-pound man out the top of it in like 2 seconds.
Yeah. Really? Have you been on it?
Yeah.
Do you have video of that? I would love to see video of that.
There's some somewhere. I've seen phones out doing it.
It's probably on YouTube or something.
And Jeff, so what's next? I mean, dang, you have surfing, you have ice skating, you have concerts, you have
What else can we expect here at Cityscape?
You know, we've been preparing for the Super Bowl for 4 years.
Right.
Almost everything that we've done down here, from live music to the comedy shows to the outdoor beach barbecues, is all kind of preparing events and engagements for the Super Bowl week. So this will be here. The ice rink will be here. You know, you're going to be able to do just about anything you could imagine in the world in downtown Phoenix. And, you know, that's what we want. We want people to bring their kids from the community to come down here for Super Bowl Central and just enjoy every element of our community.
Wouldn't that be incredible? You can ice skate, you can surf, you can listen to a concert, you just party. Wow, incredible. So, Sean, how much does it cost?
Right now, it's $10 for 30 minutes.
All right.
We allow up to 10 people in a session.
And we sell packages too.
We do.
So we've got a lot of people that want to come, and you know, they have so much fun. They come back and they say, "How can I just put my kids on the light rail?
Right.
Let them come down, and then you know, ride." And
you know, school's starting pretty soon, so even classes can come out here and
absolutely
and have a field trip, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You know, so we'll do bundles of 10. You know, you get 5 free rides. So it really is. It's really affordable, and it's easy for your kids to come down and lose themselves for hours.
Oh, wow. Now it's a great way to cool down. Now I have 6 kids of my own, and I got a couple of nephews and nieces with us. So you guys want to try it out?
Yeah!
All right, so let's go try it out. All right, summer's here, and it's always the right time to talk about water safety. You always have to watch your kids around water, no matter if it's 1 second, 2 second, or a couple minutes. You always have to watch your kids around water. And the best person to tell us about water safety is Kelly from our Phoenix Fire Department.
Hey, thank you.
Kelly, I just want to thank you for everything the Phoenix Fire has done, and especially you in training our young people about water safety.
Oh, it's a great pleasure. I mean, being the leading cause of fatalities for children 1 to 5, it needs to be addressed. So, and even not just the children, but teens and adults drowning as well. So anything we can do to prevent that, and that's where the ABCs come in. It's really basic, just adult supervision, barrier, and classes.
Hey, so, let's give them a little class.
Let's do it. Let's see what these kiddos know. What are you guys ready for a little test?
All right, let's see.
All right, hey, what does A stand for?
Adult supervision.
And what does that mean?
You have to have a person, like an adult, watching you.
Always have an adult watching you, never swim alone. What about B?
Barriers.
Barriers, that's right. And what are some barriers?
To have a fence around your pool.
Fences, yep. Doors, locks. Locks and latches on windows. And making sure doggy doors are locked and latched too when not in use. All right, and then C is for?
Classes.
And what kind of classes?
Oh, he said Carlos.
Carlos? Hey, what kind of classes?
CPR and swimming.
That's right, CPR and swim lessons. So City of Phoenix Aquatics has the swim lessons, and the United Phoenix Firefighters teach the CPR. Well done. Well done, team.
So Kelly, how can you find out more about water safety?
Say, so look on the best way is to look up phoenix.gov/fire and look at the water safety link, or even phoenix.gov/parks and then water, and you can look up the swim lessons and different water safety advice as well.
Hey, Kelly, I know that there's all kinds of different programs out there, from the Fiesta Water event to the Verano Sano. How can you get more information about those events and the free classes that are out there also?
Yeah, so all the Verano Sano with SRP, right, and everybody and all the Insignia and all the Sizzling Summer, all those classes are going to be online again at the parks on phoenix.gov/parks. Look on the websites, and even SRP's website has all the information too.
And any last messages for parents out there that have kids?
Yes. Always watch your children, and not just around water, but always. They are escaping through doggy doors, a lot of them. And then even think about in-home hazards as well, like bathtubs, sinks, dog bowls for little kids that could maybe just drop their head into a dog bowl. I've seen things like that.
So you can drown in a dog bowl?
A dog bowl. All it takes is 2 inches of water to submerge the nose and the face. And those little infants aren't really strong enough to pull their head out of the water, so even toilets as well. So locks and latches, secure your home, make your home water safe.
Well, Kelly, thank you so much for everything the firefighters have done for us and all the city of Phoenix. You guys are creating this Team Phoenix approach where you have all the different departments working together to prevent drownings. And you parents, watch your loved ones, especially your children, around water. And remember what Kelly says, it's never too old. You're never too old to learn how to swim. So if you're an adult, you don't know how to swim, learn how to swim and teach your kids at the same time. And you know what? Wouldn't that be great if we had a firefighter try the wave pool? Can you do that?
You know what? I'm going to give it my all. Let's see.
Hey, kids, do you want him to do it? Yeah, all right. Hey, peer pressure. Peer pressure.
We'll try it. We'll try it. See if I can make it.
The Phoenix Finest. All right. They'll do anything. They'll run into burning buildings, and they'll even surf for the city of Phoenix.
That's all right.
Let's go.
All right. Here we go.
And that's it for this month's Phoenix 2020, A Clear Vision for the Future. You can like me on Facebook, or you can look me up on Twitter, and you can call our office. And remember, if you want to cool down and have a cool place to bring your kids and family members, it's right here in Cityscape at The Wave.